Hey, Internet! My name is Sebbi, and welcome back to the Coffee Break in Minecraft. Today is Sunday, August. Wait a moment. Indeed, it's already August. Wow, that's crazy. That's really crazy. I can't believe it that it's already August. But okay, so today is Sunday, August 2nd, 2015. And yeah, so welcome to the first episode of Coffee Break in Minecraft in the month of August 2015. And yeah, so well, I think the good thing is that, well, August is hopefully the final summer months, and the summer is, well, at some point finally over, because yeah, the summer is really exhausting and really annoying, and for the upcoming week they predict temperatures above 30 degrees Celsius, and this will not end well for Sebbi. This will definitely not end well for Sebbi. So yeah, I can't wait for the time that the summer is finally over and that we have better temperatures. Well, the last week was okay-ish. We had temperatures a little bit above 20 degrees Celsius. This was really good, but well, for this upcoming week they, as I said, have they predict temperatures above 30 degrees Celsius, so tomorrow 34 degrees Celsius, and that's not good. That's really not good. And okay, that's sad. That's really sad. The issue with the texture still persists. So although I have added an extra layer of cobblestone, we can still look into our world. That's really sad. And yeah, in the last episode I began to lay out a path, because I really like to connect all my different locations. I like to go locate my new headquarter, my new tower, with my old cabin and with the storage room, and maybe I will even create a path over to the airport and pass over to the nether portal. And at first I like to check one thing. Do we have a drop of more than one block? No, we have not. We have not. That's amazing. That's great. So we do have already a natural staircase, and this means that I just have to add the stairs to the slope of this mountain, and then we do have a staircase, or well, and we do have the path leading up to my tower, and that's great. That's so amazing. That's great. Okay, let me do this. And well, for this episode I like to take a sneak peek into the nether. I remember that at some point I started to place a few torches to okay, I need a thing. No, not chicken. I need my crafting table. Because I remember at some point I was in the nether in order to place a few torches, so that I do have a pass. Because as I said, I like to explore the nether. I like to find a nether fortress. And so yeah, I think I like to mark my way with some torches, so that I can find my way back to the portal. And yeah, so in this case I think I will take a sneak peek into the nether to see what I have done so far. But at first, so over here I have to create the path down to the mine, because I also like to connect the mine. And yeah, if I'm then up here, I can move around here. I can move around here, and then I can move straight up to my new tower. That's good. That's great. I like this. I like this. That's amazing. That's really amazing. Yeah, that's cool. And then I'm directly in front of my entrance. That's cool. That's amazing. I like this. I like this. So well, in the last episode I was also talking about my Iceland journey, and yeah, at first, or well, at the end of last episode, I thought, oh dear, I was so scatter-minded, the whole episode will make absolutely no sense. And well, after I finished the recording and after I rendered the episode, I was watching it while it was uploading to YouTube, And well, I thought, okay, it was okay-ish. It was not that bad as I assumed it would be. And yeah, this was really good. And so I think I can just continue to talk in my scatter-mind way about the Iceland experience. And well, it was so amazing. It was so beautiful. And well, in the last episode, I think I was talking about all the geothermal effects of Iceland, of having all these geothermal active areas and taking a shower in geothermal water. Well, with this very distinctive sulfur smell. And yeah, this was really strange. And yeah, this was cool. And well, aside from this geothermal activity, Iceland features also so many beautiful waterfalls. And wow, this is so unbelievable. There are huge waterfalls, there are small waterfalls, there are wide waterfalls, there are multiple waterfalls, there are deep waterfalls, there are all kinds of waterfalls. And that's so amazing. That's so beautiful. All the time you can see a different waterfall. And well, I think really impressive was, on the one hand, oh dear, I hope I don't say no the wrong name, because I really have a hard time remembering all the names of all the different waterfalls, because we have seen so many. I think it was the Gullfoss. And well, the Gullfoss is really gigantic. It's so huge. And you can get really close to the Gullfoss. So at some point, it is almost like the water is flowing directly towards you. And yeah, it's also a little bit scary when the water is directly flowing towards you. And well, when you turn around, you can look down into the deep gorge. And well, there's so much water vapor after the, or well, because the water is falling down to this deep gorge. And this looks so amazing. This is so beautiful and so impressive. And well, then we also saw a quote unquote secret waterfall, because yeah, luckily this waterfall was not so known amongst all the tourists. Wait, I do have some arrows. I do have 4 arrows. And I need to get out of the Nether in time, because I like to stick to the 2-day schedule. And oh dear, I hear already a guest. Yeah, over there is a guest. That's not good. And yeah, over here are already some torches. That's good. Oh dear, okay. And it begins. And it begins. I need to. Yeah, shoot at me. Oh dear. I hope I can deal with this guy. Oh dear, what? Ooh, wow. So, where are you? Where are you, guy? You are disturbing my. Okay, can we? I hope we can. Dang it! He moved. Okay, very good. This was a good shot. So, yeah, waterfalls. And there was also we visited also a secret waterfall. And the most beautiful thing about this waterfall was that, well, the stream was basically running through a gorge, but there was more water than the gorge has space, basically. So the gorge was full of water. And but at some point, well, the stream has filled the whole gorge, but at some point the water, or well, no, at some point there was a drop, basically. And yeah, then the okay, I have marked already quite a distance. That's good. And even over there are torches. So I think, oh yeah, I remember I created this pathway there at the side. Okay, I think I have to come back later, because I don't have ladders, and I think I need ladders, because I think I was I completed this path, or I marked this path, until I got to a very steep drop. And so I think I have to create a few ladders and continue this. But yeah, I have begun to mark a path. That's good. That's really good. And yeah, so there was then a drop. And so this was while there was a waterfall. And the most interesting thing is because of this narrow gorge inside the stream, it looked a little bit like the waterfall, well, as there would be a hole inside the stream and the water would basically flow into a hole. And this was really impressive to see. Okay, looks like there's a hole in the stream and the water is running from all sides into this hole. And yeah, this was really beautiful. And there was also a bridge across the stream so that you were able to... Okay, the moon is rising. I think we have to sleep right next to the portal. And yeah, this was really amazing. This was a really beautiful view. And yeah, so we saw a lot of zombies. And yeah, so we saw a lot of beautiful waterfalls, and this was really impressive and really amazing. And yeah, this was really cool. And what else? Of course, the landscape I was talking about this so many times. It was so amazing because there are about no trees. Well, there are a few areas where there are some little forests, but in general there are about no trees. And yeah, so this is really, really strange. And it's so amazing when you can look so far into the distance. And yeah, this was so great. This was so beautiful. And is there another specific thing I like to talk about? Well, there are so many beautiful memories, but it's really, really hard to talk about all these things. And I don't want to be too scatter-minded and jump from topic to topic. So, waterfalls were amazing, geothermal areas, I already talked about this. Is there anything else I really like to talk about? Last episode I had the feeling that I have so many things to talk about, and now I have the slight feeling that I'm basically stuck and that I'm running out of topic, that I'm running out of content in terms of Iceland. This can't be, because there was so much going on. And, well, it's also a little bit... paper, I need more paper. It's also a little bit problematic as... how should I put this? I need... one piece of redstone to create a new compass. How should I put this at best? We do have a new map. Now I'm stuck. Perfect. Just perfect. What do I wanted to say? Oh dear, I'm lost. I'm so lost. This can't be. Okay, let's talk about a different topic while I am thinking about what I wanted to say in terms of Iceland. Well, so before I left for Iceland, I just finished the study of the learning game. And then there was an evaluation going on about the enjoyment of use and so on. And well, this or last Monday I decided, okay, now the period to evaluate the game is now over, and now it's time to look into the results. And to look into the results. And yeah, so I did this. I did some statistical analysis. And yeah, then I wrote an email to my professor, and I reported the results, and I also asked him for a meeting so that we can talk about the results and a few issues and so on. And well, on Thursday, I got a reply, and well, I got the email on Thursday around 8:30 a.m. And in the email, there was an invitation to a talk that was given at here at the university for Thursday. For Thursday around noon. And yeah, so I got the invitation, and I got the invitation for a meeting with my professor the same day. So this was really a surprise. And yeah, I got there in time, so this was okay. But this was really a surprise because, well, when you check your emails in the morning, you don't think about, okay, maybe I have an instant invitation to a meeting the same day. And well, so yeah, this was really a surprise. But yeah, it was a good meeting. We were able to talk about all the things that accumulated over the last few months, and yeah, this was really productive. And now I do have a lot of things to do for the next month, and I hope that the weather will calm down. Basically, I hope it will get colder soon, because well, during these high temperature days with more than 30 degrees, it's really hard to focus on my work, and it's really hard to focus on all the things I have to do. And yeah, in this case, I hope it will cool down soon. And am I going into the wrong direction? I'm confused. Shouldn't I get to the map at some point? Am I this far away from the map? Am I moving into the wrong direction? I'm totally confused. I'm really confused. I'm not quite sure what I'm doing. So yeah, this instant invitation was really funny. But yeah, so I got there on time, and the meeting was good. And well, even the results of the evaluation are really good. I got some good significant results. That's really amazing. So now I can start writing the paper about this. And yeah, this is really cool, and this is amazing. And it's really rewarding when you look into the results and you see, okay, yeah, the results are really what I hoped for. And yeah, so I'm really happy about this. And yeah, what else is going on? Then of course, I was talking about this, well, now we can switch a little bit back to Iceland, that on my other YouTube channel, my vlog YouTube channel, I'm releasing my vlogs are created over in Iceland. And right now I am, I finished to render all the vlogs, and now I am creating all the other videos that show a little bit more of the beautiful landscape of Iceland. And that's really a lot of work, because I created so many videos, and now I have to edit them. And yeah, I have created videos for the first 2 days, and we were there for 16-17 days, and so there is a lot of work coming up, and I'm not quite sure if I can release all the videos in one go, or if there's maybe a gap between the videos, because there's so much to do, and I'm not quite sure if I can really do this. And well, I'm getting a little bit nervous about my project. I wanted to explore the next part of the map wall, and in order to do this, I need to get out here to this map I'm currently holding in my hand. And well, as you can see on the left hand side, I'm still not on the map. And I'm mildly concerned. Am I moving into the wrong direction? I am moving into the right direction. Am I? The sun should set behind me. But I can't see the sun. I'm not quite sure where the sun is. The sun should be there. Then I should be moving into the right direction. I have no idea. Or are we now in a unexplored region? I don't know. Maybe I should have grabbed the other map to navigate. This is really curious. I really feel lost. I feel a little bit lost. And yeah, so what else is going on then, aside from these Iceland videos? I think maybe I will come back in the next episode of the Coffee Break in Minecraft to Iceland. But I think as I can't really come up with another thing I really have to talk about and that has really impressed me, and well, it's also a little bit difficult because I was talking about Iceland over the last few episodes, over the last two episodes, and so I'm not quite sure what I said during the first episode and during the last episode, and yeah, in this case it's really hard to continue talking about all the things. And yeah, the sun is setting there, so I am moving into the right direction. It's really surprising that I'm not reaching the border of this map, and well, so I think I will now end this episode over here and continue in the next episode in this direction in the hope that I finally reach the border of the map so that I can start exploring. And yeah, so okay, I am not talking about upcoming projects for my YouTube channel. Instead, I'm now going to bed, and yeah, I hope you have still enjoyed this episode, although it was once again a scatter-minded episode, and I was jumping from topic to topic, and it was really confusing, but yeah, that's the way of the coffee break in Minecraft, and I hope I will see you in the next episode on Wednesday. And yeah, so thank you so much for watching. Until next time, my name is Sebbi. See you!